Overland Jones,
Captain Morgan,
coming to you live here from Fretz RV in Philadelphia, right outside of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. We've got the stealth mode here today, and we've got the beast mode. You're going to love seeing both of these. It's going to be awesome. What a great dealership we're at today. We can't wait to show you around both of these units. Overland Jones here again at Fretz RV. This is the stealth mode. One thing I want you to notice about each of every storyteller that's out there in the marketplace today is going to have a window sticker on it, okay? We implement a see-through pricing structure, okay, where we as consumers get to see through to what the dealer paid for the unit, and that's what we pay. Pretty forwardly thinking in the industry, I will say, okay? This you can always be confident that you're getting the best deal no matter which dealership you're at in the entire country, okay? So let me show you some really cool things about the outside of the stealth mode, all right? So the first thing I want you to notice is the stripe right here on the bottom, okay? It is a recessed stripe. It is a cut-in stripe compared to a cut-out stripe, all right? It is awesome. It does give this stealth a very stealthy appearance when you look at it, all right? This is the Celebite Gray Metallic. Currently, we're sold out of this color, okay? The Stealth comes in SGM, Celebite Gray Metallic, or Blue Gray, which is also looks amazing, okay? So I want you to notice the huge automotive-grade window right here. That's really important because when you're driving down the road, you can do this, and you can look over to the side, and you can see the cars next to you, okay? Not every Class B RV has that. Not every adventure van has it, okay? Next thing I want you to notice is the Girard awning on top. Top of the line awning, all right? It's a 10x8 awning, so it's huge. It will give you enough cover, all right? Then I want you to notice the flare space right here. This flare space is insulated. That's really important because when you sleep at night, okay, you're gonna sleep, if you're tall like I am, you're gonna sleep with your feet on the flare space, all right? If it was not insulated, you would freeze, okay? It happened to me, unfortunately, at one point in time. We started to insulate the flare space, so now you're snug as a bug inside there. The next thing I want you to see is the tires that are on the outside of your stealth mode, okay? So these are 265 BF Goodrich tires with 18-inch rims, okay? This is really important because this is what touches the road. This is really the most important thing. For you have really, really high quality tires that are made here in the USA. That's a big deal, okay? Of course, the stealth badging right here is just absolutely incredible. I'm gonna keep coming around to the back. So on the stealth mode, you're going to have the StoryTeller Overland up dog step right here, okay? This is our rear step, okay? It's gonna come on the stealth mode. It's gonna come on your beast mode as well too, okay? You're gonna have your rear camera right up here. The rear camera has three different zooms, regular, wide, and zoomed in, okay? You're gonna love that rear camera. Notice on the stealth mode, the Mercedes-Benz emblem is blacked out on the back. Again, very stealthy. And then the badging on the bottom is, the belt line is all the way around to that to complete the thought. All right, come on around to this side. So we can see our driver side flare is a little bit larger than our passenger side flare. The reason for that is because we have to have the sliding door open on the opposite side, okay? Notice you also have a sliding window right here with the screen inside of it. That way you can open it up and you get that nice cross breeze all over your face, okay? Also, city water connection and fresh water connection right here, okay? Our fresh water tank sits up here. You do have to have a pressurized hose to fill your fresh water tank from this point, okay? There's an accessory that we have inside that's a way to get around that in case you have a jerry can or just a regular gallon of water that you want to fill it up with, okay? Next thing I want you to notice is the ladder, right? This is the strongest ladder I've ever been on in my entire life for any RV I've ever been on. This is incredible. Watch this, okay? So you can get on it. You can't do that with any other RV out there in the marketplace today. But you can do that with your StoryTeller Overland Adventure Van, okay? Next thing I want you to notice is the smart plug right here. This is a marine grade, so it's a waterproof power cord, okay? It gives you 100% electrical connectivity when you're plugged into 30 amp or when you have a 30 to 110 adapter, okay? What does that mean? That means all your appliances are running at maximum efficiency, okay? If you wanna look up top, just right here, you can see that we have two roof racks, not just one, but two roof racks. They're front runner roof racks. Both of them can support up to 600 pounds, okay? We don't want you to put 600 pounds on top of your StoryTeller going down the road, but they can support it once you're stopped, okay? Next thing I want you to notice is this right here, the gray tank, okay? So it's got a steel plate covering on it. That matters when you go off road and you're going down a trail. There's not any rocks that come up and bust that open, okay? The other thing that it allows us to do is passively heat this gray tank. Your gray tank won't freeze until you get to -1 degrees. That's huge. Most gray tanks aren't like that, but your StoryTeller is, okay? Next thing I want you to see is your driver's side step in, and underneath your driver's side step in is going to be the exhaust for your Rickson fuel fired heating system, okay? This is the exhaust for your secondary engine or your S-bar engine on your StoryTeller, okay? We'll keep coming around to the front. So the Stealth is just so gorgeous. It's really the most popular trim level package that we have at StoryTeller. Okay, so you get the matted front grille, you get the matted black Mercedes Benz with a Vizin one, and you get the matted front hood as well. See, gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. This front camera also has three settings on it as well too. Okay, so you're going to have a regular setting, a wide angle, and then you're going to have a low slung zoom for when you go off road. You can kind of see what's up over the hill, and that's a big deal in these adventure vans. Okay. Also, if you can see right here on the very top, okay, we have a sonic wedge wind deflector on the top. So what that's going to do is that's going to cut down on any kind of vibrations that you're going to have for your max air vent on the inside of your RV, okay?
Hey, Captain Morgan here at Fretz RV, here with the StoryTeller Stealth and the StoryTeller Beast. I'm going to show you the inside here and go over feature benefits for you.
All right, this is the exterior table here that folds down. This is going to be one of the areas where you use most because everyone's out here camping underneath your awning. You have your 110 outlet here where you can use your cooktop and you can, you know, plug anything else that you need there and hang out here, your blender, doing all your camping. One cool feature here with our isotherm refrigerator is that it opens up 180 degrees so you can access anything you need here, or any drinks or anything like that, so that you can easily access everything that you need. You have your light panel here where you have your awning lights. You have your awning control here. You have your awning in, auxiliary for if you hook up anything else on top of the roof, it's already wired for that. And then you have your interior lights right here as well. So why don't you come on up here and we'll take a look at everything inside.
All right, so this is the interior of our StoryTeller Stealth. The Stealth model and the Mode and the Beast are all going to be very, very similar inside. Stealth and Mode are exactly the same internally. And the Beast has a few different options that we'll show you in a minute. But right here is our control panel. This is the same as everything. When you come into your StoryTeller, you just simply push one button to turn it on. You push the second button to turn your inverter on so that you can run your AC and everything that you need to. We have our water system monitor here. This gives you percentages. It doesn't give you quarter or half. So you'll see here 0%. And then on your gray tank, we're at 15%. So you have an idea of where you're at. This here is your AC and your heat. One awesome feature about this is this bolted power system tells you what watts you're pulling. If I select here and I turn on my AC that's running off of my bolted power system, you'll notice here that in live mode here, you have about 1,030 watts pulling on that AC. So you always know how much power you're pulling that's running through your inverter, and you're going to know what you can accomplish with that. Very simple system, just like your home thermostat. This right here is your Rickson furnace system. You turn your light on here, you turn your furnace and your hot water on, and then this will give you your heat. It will give you your hot water. You're able to run instant hot water on demand. So as long as you have hot water, or as long as you have water, you will have hot water. If you come right here, this fantastic device here is called our Groove Lounge. It's multi-purpose, multifunctional. Since we don't have a hard shell closet here, or bathroom space, we're able to have different, I'm going to shut this here real quick. We're able to have an option for a second bed here, a lounger, a love seat, and I'll show you how that works. It's very simple. You take this off here. You flip this down here. Flip this down with this lever. Flip this down with this lever. And now you have yourself a second bed. It will fit somebody 6 foot. If you're extended like this with the seat swiveled around, then you could get somebody up to upwards of 6'5" on here. If you put this guy up here and this one down, you now have a love seat. With the swivel seats there and the love seats here, you can sit up to 5 people, adults playing cards or whatever you're doing, hanging out at your camp spot. If you're out at the beach or up in a beautiful mountain area, you have a rear facing lounger so you can get the view out of the back there. Put this side down, raise this side up so that you can take a nice little siesta in between long drives so you have full shoulder support and neck support so you can rejuvenate yourself there. And then we have drive mode. Drive mode has 2 3-point seatbelt harnesses. They have been pull tested and DOT approved, so you can put 2 car seats here safely. It's 74 inches wide, so both car seats will fit here no problem. They also recline at whatever degree you want for a little more comfort if you have kids sitting here or adults sitting here. And one feature that we put in here is a valuable safe. So maximizing all the space that's available to us. Like I said, multifunctional, multi-purpose. Speaking of multifunction and multi-purpose, we come on over here and you have your step. This step is to get into your bed that I'll show you in a minute, but it also doubles as a shower pan and storage for your portable cassette toilet that you have here. It also triples as an ice chest. You're thinking, why is there a shower pan here? I don't see a shower, right? We'll open up your cabinet here and we have our Halo shower system right here. Very simple to use. You undo these 2. You drop that down. Pull these Velcro straps. Let that roll down and pull it out. Now you have your Halo shower system. This is a high quality parachute material. It's antimicrobial. It's self-wicking, so it won't stick to you when you're wet. We have magnet openings on your shower. So you can simply just get in and allow yourself a lot of room to move around in there. A lot more room than you will on a hard shell. And most of the time we're not taking a shower. We're just taking a shower to get clean real quick in between trips or after a couple days of camping. So instead of having a shower here all the time, we can now put this away. And now it's completely out of the way and we have way more living space. We have a full open floor plan and we maximize our ability to use this 144 inch chassis. So right here is our kitchen galley. This is our sink. We have a full depth sink so you can actually wash a pan in here, a full size pan. And you're wondering, where is a cooktop? Well, we make that portable for you so that you can use it anywhere that you want. You can use it here on the counter. Just plugs into your 110 outlet here. You can use it outside on your outdoor table. And then you can also use it here on your workbench or your prep table that I'll show you in a second as well. So I want you to see something here, and it's the quality of our cabinetry and our drawers. You'll see solid wood, dovetail here. Very, very nice and very simple. You just push those in, set that in, push it in, and you're done. Nothing in here is difficult to use. You have your microwave here as well. So you have microwave while you're out camping. What you'll see here is a 12 volt plug. You have USB ports throughout as well. And then you have your max air vent fan, which is automatic and just works by a touch of a button. You come on back here. Now we're in our garage space. Okay. So that we have an L-track system on here, so you can tie down anything that you need. You can store bikes in here. This is designed to have the height for 29-inch mountain bikes. So you can definitely have enough storage here. Bring this down, our bed system, our Dreamweaver bed system. Take up your mattress pad here. Now you have a prep table, or you have a changing table, or you have a workbench. This will hold 400 pounds on this side. With the bed fully down, you hold 800 pounds. So it's plenty strong enough for anything that you can throw at it. Take your cushions. And you fit them in. You want to do this side here, and it will fold right down. And again, your step, get on your bed. And so on the widest spot here, you can sleep up to 6'5". In this area, on this side of the flare spaces. Over here, you can fit 6'3". So like you know, we insulate our entire van with Havelock wool. We put it in every nook and cranny. It's self-wicking, it doesn't hold moisture, it doesn't sag, it gives great acoustics here. We also pad and coat everything in our fabric. So this is the quietest RV that you'll ever drive. It's really incredible. We insulate the flare spaces. We insulate the rear doors. We insulate every nook and cranny. That allows us to have our pipes to not freeze until negative 17 degrees. So you can go up to your mountain and go snowboarding, go skiing. Do any camping that you want there. Everything is very simple to use, easy to put away, quick. I want you to look at the quality here. So this is a composite door frame. It's not going to swell or shrink, so it's going to hold a high tolerance so that you're not getting any rattle. We pad and wrap everything in fabric in our cabinet so you don't have anything there. Check out these hinges here. These are high quality hinges. Nobody in the market uses these. These are aluminum welded frames that are powder coated. And check this out. I'm shaking the whole van with our cabinet here. Extreme quality here. You're gonna get what you pay for with StoryTeller. So we have this garage space here. Again, our lights light up anything that you need here. Let's see, what am I missing here?
So we run a Coleman 13.5 BTU AC that can run on our battery system. It's a 12 kilowatt Volta energy system is what we like to call it. That allows you to run your AC anywhere from 10 to 12 hours, depending on ambient temperatures. And it will recharge with an 8 kilowatt alternator. That alternator will charge your battery from 0 to 100 in about an hour and 20 minutes. There's nothing like it on the market. It's really incredible. That allows you to be completely off-grid and not worry about if you're going to be able to use your power or not, because you're going to have plenty of power here. We have 21 gallons of fresh water here stored behind here. Our Volta power system is stored right back here. And our 3700 amp inverter is stored right here. You have access to your plumbing lines here in case you need to get to those when you winterize. Your tubes are going to be right here. So very easy access to anything that you need in the van at any given time. You're going to have a 3-year 1,000 life cycle warranty on that Volta system. You're going to have a 1-year 15,000 on your StoryTeller, anything that we manufacture here. We also have a Mode Life app that you can video FaceTime us and ask any questions. We can diagnose any problem, order the parts for you. We can ship them to the dealership or your house and have a mobile tech come to you, or you can go to the dealership where you're going to be taken care of. You're going to get better service with us than any manufacturer out there. We promise that. We're here to change the RV industry, and we can't wait for you to become a StoryTeller.
All right, now we're checking out the outside of the beast mode. Yes, I do have on the beast mode shirt, okay? And you can see that this still has the see-through pricing structure and window sticker on it right here, okay? The beast mode retails for a little bit over $189. Again, you always are getting the best deal in America, no matter what dealership you're at with a StoryTeller, okay? So the beast mode, if you want to check it out, look at these awesome stripes right here. Okay, all the way back down to the end, and they come up and they match the tail lights. The actual hue of each light, each one matches here. So it's very much by design, okay? The next thing that you're going to notice about the beast mode is it is very beastly. It has an upper stance like this. Why is that? We have a rip kit by Agile Off-Road right here, or a ride improvement package, okay? So what this is going to do is going to give you about 2 extra inches of lift. It's going to improve your ride tremendously, okay? Now, the next thing that we have is we put out this front wheel flare right here, okay? So now, instead of 265s that are available on the Classic and the Stealth, you have 275 size tires that are available on your beast mode, okay? We also give you this extra wheel flare right here. Again, it gives it a very beastly look. Black Rhino rims, incredible, okay? So you're gonna have 15 and a half inches of ground clearance on the beast right here to the bottom of your running boards. That's incredible, all right? Notice the bottom is still matted black underneath the belt line. Gives it that great look. Of course, the automotive grade outdoor window right here. Flare space is also insulated on this side right here. So now we're at the rear of the beast mode, okay? So what we've got is a lot of really great storage solutions for you, okay? So this is an Al Van Sherpa board. This gives you the ultimate ability to customize and the freedom of functionality to use your storage equipment in the manner that you see fit, okay? There's endless options that you can add to this, whether it's trash, jerry cans, storage boxes, whatever you want to do, shovels, axes, you can put them on here however you want to, okay? I love the Sherpa boards from Alavance. We also have the Alavance spare tire carrier, okay? This is really important because both of these are mounted on the hinges on the outside, and then there's one bolt that goes through the door in the middle, okay? So the hinges of these doors are carrying the brunt of the weight right here, okay? Also, we have the up dog step on the back of the beast right here as well, too, okay? You want to come around on this way? Again, same exact thing with your fresh water and your city water connection right here. Same exact thing with your insulated flare space and your sliding window with the screen, okay? This also has the strongest ladder I've ever been on in my life, okay? I mean, it is unreal just how strong this ladder is. You can't do that on any other RV. That's a big deal, okay? So, another thing that's very different about the beast mode is going to be the roof rack. On this side, you can kind of see the spotlights that we have on the corners, but then you have an upgraded front light bar, you have an upgraded front tin zinc bumper with lights, KC lights on it too, and then the round KC lights, the iconic KC lights that are so very cool, okay? Also, you have the smart plug power cord right here. Again, that's a marine grade power cord, 100% waterproof. And then, of course, your gray tank is still plate covered, okay? Passively heated down to negative 1 degrees. Front driver step with the Rekon fuel-fired exhaust system right here for your S-bar engine, okay? Again, these gorgeous stripes right here. So this is a really cool option that we have. You have one on the rear and one on the front. You have the ability to air up your tires and air them down right here. We have a dual chamber ARB air compressor on board of this unit right here. You crank your engine up, you turn your air compressor on the inside. You can air up and air down very, very quickly with this. This is awesome. I just love it so very much. It is incredible. So if you keep coming to the front, you can kind of see the connection right here where this has the quick connect in it. Right here, so it's already plumbed, it's already, all the air hoses have already been ran. One of the things that I love about the beast mode is this stripe in the front, okay? It just gives it this really mean, really gnarly look that is incredible. Also, look at the KC lights on the top, okay? Each one of those on the interior, you're gonna have what looks like airplane switches, really super high quality switches to turn those on and off. Yes, they do come with covers, okay? In the state of California, you do have to have covers on those lights. It is against the law. You ride around with covers off of those lights. I believe that's the only state that has that law, but we have the covers for you all the time right here. These are super simple. They just come right off the top, okay? And the thing I like about them is because they have these corners, they can't kind of get sideways. They go on perfectly straight whenever you're done, okay? This is a StoryTeller tin zinc front bumper right here. This is really important because you have the sensors in this front bumper that still give you the ability to have your adaptive cruise control, okay? This also has the camera in the front, and all StoryTellers come with the bird's eye view, the 360 degree bird's eye view. So when you put it in reverse, it looks like a drone sat on top of you or a bird is actually looking down. And that's your beast mode.
Hey, Captain Morgan back here. We're in the beast now. I'm gonna show you a few features that are just a tiny bit different on the interior than on the stealth and on the mode. So one thing you notice here is the special badging and this plate here. This is your StoryTeller beast mode number plate. So this is beast mode number 7. So we do a very limited production on these, about 50 a year. So they're very limited. So we kind of wanted to add that, like, you know, boutique style thing to it by putting a number plate on there. It is glow in the dark as well. What you'll see here is this really cool light switch system, you know, like your cockpit and in your airplane where you flip your lights on to get ready to go and they light up to let you know that they're on. Very high quality here. Super cool feature. You also see this right here. This is your onboard air compressor button. So when you need air for your tires, when you low down or need to air back up, you just switch that on and your air compressor comes on there. One more feature that is different here is this right here. This is your boost mode, your auto start arm and your boost mode. You click that on and at 20%, your battery gets to 20%, your engine will automatically start. And it will charge it to 50%. It's gonna give you around 5 hours more of AC at constant running. You push the red button there and you'll get about 58 to an hour and 15 minutes of running time to charge that. And it is on a clock. So if you turn it off and then turn it on 30 minutes later, it will still work. That allows you to
use your system however you need to. It's your battery management system. Some other things that you're going to notice on the beasts that are different are these bags, these storage bags here. These come standard on the beast. You get a bag on each end of the seat. If you follow me over here, you also get your galley. And there's another one back over here. And then you have your garage storage bags as well. These come stock on the beast. You can order them online on our website, www.storytelleroverland.com, and purchase them there if you were to purchase a stealth or a mode and you wanted those accessories. But if you purchase a beast, it's standard on there. One other item that is on here is your shower caddy. So you can put your toiletries here, and you have a little mirror if you want to use that to shave or you know, just make sure you got soap off your face or whatever you need. So that's the main difference between the beast interior and all the rest. Floor plan is exactly the same. All your power systems the same, your AC, nothing's different, just those couple features that I showed you there. So have a wonderful day, and thank you for watching.